Hey, how you doing this afternoon? My name is Matthew Wright. I go by Matt, though, and I'm a spiritual leader and teacher in Richmond, and I'm also a spirit medium and intuitive, psychic, and empathic intuitive.
My name is Jeremy Elliott. I'm also from Richmond, Virginia. I'm a spiritual leader and teacher, psychic, clairvoyant, and medium.
Yeah. And just before we begin, we touch on the quick explanation of how we do things. We do a lot of things as far as spiritual teaching and grief retreats and help people in the pain understand death and whatnot. But we have people from the other side on the spirit world. Sometimes spirits come to us for help. Sometimes it's physical people coming to us to contact the spirit world. We see spirits all the time, We've known this dude Fluff for a minute, man. I think y'all call him Fluff or Bishop or whatever, both. Yeah. But, he's come through before. But, we were like, well, I'm telling him, look, why don't you talk to your people, let them know you're all right, That's what I felt maybe should be a good,
Yeah, it's showing me somebody with a C.
Let me describe him. I'll let Jeremy talk.
He's going back and forth from having in the spirit world. You can kind of change up, But when I first saw him, he had like braids in his hair, sunglasses on, kind of light skin, and a bomber jacket on, baggy jeans, then a red hat appeared. But then I could see him with short hair,
And darker skin.
Yeah, I see him with darker skin. It's interesting because it's like outfits.
He enjoys changing his clothes, and his appearance. A lot of spirits do. He just thinks it and it happens. He thinks like red hat, pop, bomber jacket, come.
That's right.
He's like, oh, let's put on different sneakers, pop, pop.
He likes his outfits, is what he's saying.
So you have all the outfits you want on
that
set.
Hey, what's up, Josh?
Hey, man, what's going on, brother, man?
What's up?
Chilling, man. Chilling as always. Doing our thing, my brother.
Me too.
Glad to hear it, man.
Once again, we're hanging out.
Yeah? You cool. I would have liked to know you. No, but we're hanging out now. I was about to say cool to hang out with you in the physical, but hey, it's just as hanging out now as it is then.
Right.
I mean, that's the way, what I'm saying, brother? We don't look at spirits any different from people,
He's right.
You're here just as real as them. Anyway. But, what were you saying about the C thing? Come back to that.
He's showing me a C name, you know what I'm saying?
C.
Yeah. He's motioning the C, you know what I mean?
C.
Yeah.
This a girl?
Yeah.
I felt it was a girl, yeah.
Yeah, female.
Is your girlfriend or something?
I can't get the name, though, you know what I'm saying? I'm not very good.
They don't give names, but yeah. They do letters so much for some reason.
They push the motion,
Yeah.
And things more than they can straight out say names,
But it's C. I guess it's your girl, man, or someone?
Yeah.
Girlfriend or something?
Sister, maybe,
Sister. Okay.
The girl, a significant female,
I got you.
Yeah.
He's
just saying that, a significant female.
Shouting out to her,
Yeah, what's her name? I can't see her name, you know what I'm saying? I can't.
I don't know, I think Candy or Andis or this or D.
Maybe something, yeah.
Andis, I see Candice, Candy, or something like that with the cut, with the C or
yeah,
the
cut sound in the S.
Yeah.
This, maybe that's instead of Enas or anything like that, you know what I mean?
I guess.
Yeah, or ends or anything like that. It's more of something else. Yeah, he's showing, he said, what's up?
What's up to her?
Yeah, what's up?
Yeah. Because, look, he's all right. I want to touch on this, He's happy, like I said, we've hung out with him before, he's happy, he's fine. He might have gone out in a violent way,
But worried about me. Nobody worried about me.
Yeah, because another thing is, they know when you're grieving or happy for him or anything, they know your thoughts. It can be tough on him or any spirit. If you're sad all the time or worried, it's hard on him. So no need to worry, right? Yeah. No need to worry. I mean, trust me, the way he's happy now, you don't need to worry. Buddha, which sometimes Lord Buddha comes through to us. I just want to explain that Buddha has helps us with this. Go ahead, Lord Buddha. I'm sorry.
No worries. Yeah. That's what I said. No worries. Just to say, you know, that he's a well-adjusted spirit, you know, and a good human being, and well-known amongst his people. You know, he's famous in this world and in that world, just as any other famous person would be. You know, he is himself, Bishop is a god. I don't know why I said that.
Okay. Continue, Lord Buddha. Is that what you had to... Please continue.
That's all.
Okay. All right. Now, he said, like, you know, Lord Buddha was commenting on him. He said he is Bishop as a god. You know?
Yes. Like, that's a good point. You know, like, we're all gods, you know?
Exactly.
And he's justifying himself. You know, changing his outfits and things. He's happy. He's well-adjusted, you know? Hell yeah. That's what he said.
Yeah. Because you are a god. You know, Jeremy and I are gods. Lord yes. Buddha is a god.
That's right.
You know, you guys are gods watching this video. You just don't know it.
Correct.
You know? Like, you know, like you have the power of the universe and you're within you. You can do anything. No one's telling you not to do it. And when you get to that point and realize that, hey...
Jesus came in.
All right, Christ is here.
I'm sorry, I just wanted to say this.
Okay.
He come in, you know.
They all come in sometimes and help, so... Yeah.
They think highly of him, you know what I'm saying? Bishop, you know, this is what he's saying to me, you know, that he's a well-adjusted, good young man, you know. Why they're coming through like this, I don't know.
Go ahead.
You know, they think a lot of him. You know, he must have done something very good.
Profound or something.
Yeah.
Lord Christ, please continue. I mean, just, do you have anything? I don't mean to cut anything.
No, it's just praising him, you know?
That's right. You know, sometimes names that come up in this world have a lot more meaning, you know? You call yourself Bishop, right?
That's right.
You know? And yet, it is your Bishop, the God.
Yeah.
Lord Bishop.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, it's appropriate, you know, nickname for, or name, you know, for himself, you know?
Very much so.
You know, it's, well, it's kind of outstanding to have, you know, two lords come in, you know, at the same time, you know, that are so well known for anybody, you know.
Keep going. All right. Jerry's phone rang, but we're going to, of course, continue. But yeah, Lord Buddha and Lord Christ both praising him. Now, the thing is, though, on the other side, they all hang out, like, as far as we've seen Lord Krishna, Lord Christ, and Lord Buddha. Come through all the same time talking with us, you know. There's no separate religions or beliefs on the other side. It's all one, you know what I'm saying? Like, you know, Buddha came in, he saw Christ. It's not like they're separate things that don't talk to each other.
Right. They
all know each other, you know. They all work together.
They must hang out with him.
And they hang out with Bishop.
Or something, you know, because, correct, you know, they know him. Now, see, I don't think everybody on the other side necessarily leaps to meet each other, but they choose who they want to meet, you know, maybe that, you know.
I mean, Lord Buddha, Lord Christ, I'm giving the impression that you've known this soul for a long time, maybe, you know, like he's had other lives.
He was a follower of Jesus when he lived in this world.
I gotcha.
You see what I'm saying?
No, I mean, talk about his past.